Hello friends, this is my review on various lighters which use gas or petrol as fuel. So by gas I mean the Zippo fluid or petrol or kerosene. I had seen a couple of videos by Russian hacker or somebody who had recommended a lot of lighters, and based upon his video I had bought a couple. But then I realized that they did not know much about the lighters themselves or how to select the best lighter. They were just buying products and displaying, which is good in a way, but in my video I'd like to tell you how to select the best lighters. Here is one lighter which I use for formal occasions. This is stylish. You can fill the gas fluid over here, so it can work with both Zippo fluid or petrol. There is a switch here. You press this and it opens like this. Here is another lighter. So all these lighters have different working mechanisms. Here this lighter is a place where you can press and it opens and there's a flame over here. And again you can fill the gas from this. This lighter has a different working mechanism. So here there is a flywheel. This opens the cover. When it releases, this flywheel rotates and generates a spark. This is a trench lighter which I bought seeing the recommendation of one of the YouTubers, but this was one of the worst purchases which I could buy. The gas did not last for even 3 days, and I'll tell you why in a moment. Here is another lighter, very simplistic design. So you open the cover like this and you light it, ignite it. This is another one. This is based on the old World War II era Ronson lighters, British one. This is a Chinese knockoff. Here you depress it and the mechanism generates a spark. This is a Chinese knockoff of a Zippo lighter, so you know how it works. This is one Zippo lighter. So you can know if it's a Chinese knockoff by the sound it makes when it opens. This is another match lighter. So you have petrol in here. You open the knob. There is a flint and a bit of wick here. And there is a flint seal here. You strike it here like this, generates a spark, lighting the fluid. So now I'm making a decision to buy a lighter. Two things are of the prime importance. One is that the lighter port where you fill the fluid should have a rubber basket which is also called a O-ring seal. If this is not there, the gas will evaporate. See, if you can look closely, there is a black gasket over here. So all these lighters which I have bought, I made sure that they have this black gasket, also called O-ring seal. It prevents the fluid from escaping. Second thing is that the overall enclosure here should not have a lot of space. If it has a lot of space, there is a lot of air here which allows the gas to evaporate. So you can see there is a small cap here which covers the wick part in an airtight block. It prevents the gas from escaping. So these lighters typically can last 10 days or 15 days of moderate to heavy use with a single refill without the gas escaping. This trench lighter which I got, it works like this. You twist it like this, it opens exposing the wick, and there is a striker here and it lights. Now you can see that there is a huge chamber inside, and therefore it allows a lot of gas to escape, to vaporize. So every time you open this, lot of gas evaporates, vaporizes, and the fuel tank gets empty in a couple of days. So I'll light these one by one and show you how the flames look. I'll not fill these. So this problem also exists with these Zippo lighters. You can see that there is a huge cap here, has a huge space here. which allows the gas to escape. So Zippo lighter refill typically lasts for 3 to 4 days. And the Zippo fluid being so expensive, I don't prefer using Zippo lighters at all. The best lighter which I've been using for the last 1 or 2 years, I saved for the last. I will explain to you the working of this in detail. I just put a couple of drops on the wicks of each and ignite them just to show you. I put a little petrol in the syringe and safely close the cap of the petrol. Safety first. First, this one. Just putting a couple of drops on the wick. And it should light. Then similarly, we'll try this one. Let's see if this lights up. This one. There you go. Put the plug back. Release it. So these lighters are not flame proof. Again, on the strange lighter, I'll do the same thing. Open it, light a spark. You can see a black smoky flame coming out. And on the side of this flame, you can see. As you can see, this is very crude and does not light all the time. Another problem with this is that the flint steel here gets eroded very quickly, and the wick here also gets damaged, cannot hold much fuel, and therefore does not light properly all the time. So this is, you can consider to be a novelty lighter to be used for a few times only. The best lighter which I saved for last is called the Imco. This is made in Sweden. The model number is 6700, Super 6700. This was a lighter which was used by the fighter pilots during World War II, the German pilots of the Nazi era. However, as you know, the history is written by the victors. So the Zippos gained more fame and this ran into obscurity. The people who know about lighters love this and keep buying it. The companies, the Swiss company stopped manufacturing this model in the year 2010. And so now these lighters have become very priced. They cost about $30-$40 on eBay. And you can get Chinese knockoffs from AliExpress for $10-$12. So how this works is that there is a sliding cover here through which you can regulate the flame. You click it like this and the lighter burns. I've been using it regularly for the past 2 years. It has a very small form factor and one filling lasts for a month. So basically you can fill the gas from here. And you can see I've kept an extra flint here. There is another place to keep the flint, which is inside this mechanism. So this is a spring mechanism, and here you can keep an extra flint as well. You can change the size of the flame by operating this. Another unique feature of this lighter is that after you have lit it, you can withdraw this tube here like this. And you can use it to light a fire. So this is the best lighter which I have used till now, and I continue using this. I only use the other lighters on rare occasions. This is called an Imco lighter. So I hope you have liked this honest review. It will save you money buying lot of other fancy lighters which have no practical use and which are basically gas guzzlers. I hope this is helpful to all you guys who are interested in lighters.